Everyone, and thank you for being here. Today marks the end of a long road for the University of Louisville. This morning, the NCAA issued its decision in the case of alleged violations involving our men's basketball program. As evidenced by their decision, our position was well represented in the hearing. And now we're ready as a program and a university to put the past behind us and move forward. We have a new coach, a new athletic director, and a new team that's ready to make the Cardinal Nation proud on and off the court. Going forward, our fans should expect a winning program and a winning culture. In entering the IARP, UofL had hoped to ensure a fair process, and today's action by the IARP reinforces that decision. Throughout this process, the university's been open, honest, and thorough in discovering and owning any mistakes that were made, and we were aggressive in making steps to ensure that major violations would not happen again in this program. We revised, strengthened, and in some instances implemented new policies and procedures to ensure compliance with all NCAA rules and regulations. I want to reiterate that none of our current coaches and student athletes were in any way involved in the allegations. I also want to remind the fans that the university acted swiftly and strongly to argue our case, hiring one of the top litigators in the nation. We felt and continue to feel strongly that our players and our fans deserve the best effort possible to protect our program. I want to thank all our fans for your patience and continued support during this very lengthy process. Today, we close the book on the past. We ask all of the Cardinal Nation to get behind these young men and all our teams as we move into a brighter future. Thank you. And now, Josh.
Mine's going to be even shorter than that. With the IARP announcement earlier today, we can finally turn the page on a long and arduous process. Thank you to Chairman Bink and the panel for taking the time to thoroughly review the facts of our case. We were hopeful for a positive outcome through this process, and that's what we received today. That said, let's not forget the impact these allegations and this lengthy process have had on this university, this program, and this fan base. It should be noted that former and current players, coaches, staff, and their families have all been significantly impacted because of these allegations. At the end of the day, we are relieved this process is finalized and we can now direct our full attention to the future of our men's basketball program. For our university, the Louisville community, and our loyal and passionate fans, today marks the beginning of a new chapter. With that, I'll take questions.
Josh, this is for the Associated Press. It's finally over now. What does it mean moving forward, and how does it feel to finally get this behind you and get things back in order?
It means exactly that. It's finally over. There's been a cloud over this program for over 5 years now, whether it's recruiting or just the fans feeling the impact of it, the staff, the athletic staff, the university staff. And for all of that to just be lifted today, obviously we have some things that we're going to have to do from a penalty standpoint, and we'll make sure that we do that. But it's relief. It feels good.
Josh, the IARP representative today said that whatever has changed in the landscape of college athletics did not impact their decision, that the time served essentially wasn't considered a factor. But does that in your mind feel like that was some of the punishment, the 5 years the program endured?
That was a lot of the punishment. If you look at as positive of a day as this is, we can't forget the last 5 years and what it's done to this program, the millions of dollars that this program has spent, the millions of dollars that this program has lost, the opportunity for student athletes to compete at the highest level, which is the expectation when they come to the University of Louisville. Yeah, it's been a big impact. I don't think anybody can undersell how much of an impact it's been. And it's not going to go away today, right? We're going to have to build this program back up. But today's a step in the right direction to do that.
Josh, could you just, right here,
yeah, there you go.
Could you clarify some of the timeline? Did you know anything going into this morning? When did you find out? And kind of that feeling of when you did find out, what was it like for you?
No. contrary to a lot of the text messages that I sent to some folks in this room, I was telling everybody the truth. I had no idea. And obviously the IIRP, I think, was intentional in that. But found out about just shortly after 9 a.m. this morning. So had a little bit of time to digest it, I think, before obviously the public did. And like I said, the reaction was, on one hand, it's positive, right? There's finality to it. You're excited to see that this team has an opportunity to compete at the highest level and try to achieve some things that maybe they thought they weren't going to be able to achieve. From Kenny and his staff to be able to just talk to recruits and say, hey, as soon as you decide to attend the University of Louisville, you're going to get the opportunity to play for a championship. That means something. It really, really means something. So, like I said, as good of a day as today has been, it is bittersweet. As everybody knows, I wasn't here for all 5 years here. But as I talk to fans, as I talk to staff, this significantly impacted this program, this basketball program, this university, this athletic department, and that is somewhat in the rearview mirror now.
Fred Calgill, WOKY. This is a pivotal moment, I would think, for you guys. Would you talk more about the collateral damage that this has caused, even looking ahead for a while? I mean, it's not like this goes away with a flip of a switch in terms of what you're dealing with in the near term, much less the medium term.
Yeah, I think if you look at historically, call them traditionally powerful programs in football or basketball or whatever sport it may be, that foundation was laid years and years and years ago. And so while I think there's an opportunity, and I'm confident that we'll get back to where we were, it's going to take time. You know, you don't just turn the page and say, hey, everything's okay. We're going to have to build this foundation back up. And that was obviously some of the decision that went into hiring Kenny, and then obviously Kenny's decisions to hire his staff. And so it's going to take some time, but this gives us the opportunity to turn that page and I think really head in the right direction, and that's what we're going to be focused on.
Rick Bozich, WDRB. With Kenny and with the previous coaching staffs, were you ever informed of specific situations where they said, you know, we're getting killed in recruiting, the other schools are saying don't go to Louisville because of this?
Yeah, constantly. Yeah. Coaches are highly competitive. They're going to use every advantage they can get. And that was, we were at a competitive disadvantage, and other programs tried to take advantage of it.
Josh, I think you were part of this. It's been 5 years. When they decided to go to the IARP, mm-hmm. Can you just kind of speak on that decision and maybe looking back now how it was the right decision, even though it took a lot longer maybe?
Yeah, ultimately it was referred there from the NCAA. Obviously, that was the route we wanted it to go. And I think the biggest thing that it did was create the opportunity for an objective group of people to hear all of the facts. And based on the decision today, I think that's what transpired, as opposed to maybe folks that had a preconceived notion going into us explaining our side of it. I think the facts were heard. Obviously, I think the panel listened to them, and I think we presented a very strong argument, and I think that's why we got to the decision that we did today.
Throughout this whole process, has there been any reevaluation of the relationship with Adidas?
No. I think if you look at that relationship and you look, once again, if you look at the facts, you know, this wasn't the CEO, the president of Adidas saying, hey, go do this or that. This was some employees, and I think they have 10,000 plus employees. Find me an organization that doesn't have a few bad actors amongst 10,000. And so I think we're committed to that relationship and confident in the future of that partnership.
Yes, please. So if you wouldn't mind going up there. Thank you. So many schools, athletics is a huge part of the face of the program, for lack of a better thing, and so many schools have been so successful using athletics. What has this done to you guys in the short term in a not positive way, but also now building on that? I mean, to the question I asked Josh, this is sort of a pivotal moment for you guys, I would think, on the entire history of the school.
So when you have a strong athletic program, it draws students to the school. They come to celebrate, and even if they're not on a team, they want to be part of the team. And we know that when a team wins the national championship the following year, applications to the universities go up, and bookstores sell out of the swag that claims the victory. So we've lost out on that. Now, our enrollments have been good, but we want to build student interest in athletics, and I think this will help us start to do that.
This one's for both of you, and I realize it's a bit difficult to answer, but hindsight's 2020. You've mentioned the swift action that the university took in making staff changes, administrative changes. Do you revisit those decisions at all after what's been released and decided today, or do you think that ultimately helped arrive at this decision for the IARP?
So from my perspective, I wasn't in Kentucky when all this happened, so I'm not going to try to guess about past decisions. I do think that we were given a very fair hearing, and our lawyers presented a fantastic case and were able to rebut most of what the CCU was arguing, and you can see that in the report. So I think that past decisions are past decisions, and we are where we are today.
Yeah, I would answer parasimilarly. I think the only thing I might add is I'm not going to look back at any decision that was made previously. For me, this day is about looking forward. Similar to Lori, I wasn't here. I wasn't in Kentucky when those decisions were made. And for me, we're focused on the future.
Anyone else? Sean LeBeau.
How does this, if at all, affect maybe reassessing putting up a 2013 national championship banner?
For me, it checks this situation off the to-do list, which allows us to focus on potentially other things on the to-do list. And while I'm not going to sit up here and make any promises, I can tell our fan base unequivocally that if there's an opportunity for us to do something along those lines, we're going to try to do it.
Right.
Josh, you mentioned last week the repeat offender status. You didn't know how it might impact this case. And so the momentum seemed to be going in favor of not punishing current student athletes for previous transgressions. But I wonder how concerned were you in these weeks leading up when you knew it was coming soon that you might have a different result than, say, NC State or Memphis had?
Yeah, I think for the group that was in that room, I think you get a tenor of how people felt about it. And I do think we felt positive walking out of that hearing room. But I always try to, I guess, make sure I know or what I try to be as realistic as I can. Let's go with that, right? And so I think it's my job to think best case, worst case, and everything in between scenarios. And so, yes, it crossed my mind. What is the worst case scenario? It crossed my mind. What is the best case scenario? But I would tell you that I think we are, I know that we're happy with the outcome today.
You mentioned the toll it's taken on the program. Obviously, attendance has fallen off. Winning helps cure that, and the new coaching staff. Will it require a marketing campaign or a letter-writing campaign to fans or a pep session or something to try and get people more back on board?
It's everything, right? It's if you're a University of Louisville fan and you don't feel better after today, after this morning, then I'm not sure you're a fan. So I think that's the beginning. And then how do we continue, as I've constantly said to our staff, as I've said to you guys, we just have to stack one good day on top of another. And I think that's happening with football right now. And so how do we make sure that it happens with basketball? So it's not just wins and losses. Winning cures a lot. We all know that. The folks in Knoxville can tell you that right now. But we have the tradition from a basketball standpoint to be one of the elite programs year in and year out in this country. And that's our expectation. That's our fans' expectation. And that's what we're going to try to achieve.
Somewhat related, you know, a lot of fans are excited, obviously, about this, and one of their first thoughts is, what about the banner? Any thoughts on moving forward with a possible change there or anything like that?
Yeah, I think I just addressed that question, that, you know,
you have to make sure that you know where your priorities lie relative to the things that you're tasked to do, and this was priority number one from an NCAA standpoint. And like I said, with this off the to-do list here, essentially, I mean, we obviously have some things that we're going to have to follow through with. I think it gives us an opportunity to say, is there the potential to do something there relative to a completely different topic? And like I said, we'll take a look at it, and if there's an opportunity, then we will.
Yeah, the panel and the NCAA seem pretty adamant that the changing landscape over the past 5 years with NIL and such didn't really play a factor in all of this. But as an athletics director, do you view issues like this in a different lens now with those changes that have been made in the past 5 years?
Well, once again, I think you have to base decisions in the moment. And so they base their decisions on what the rules were 5 years ago. Those rules have changed, and now it's our job to make sure we're adhering to the current set of rules. And so that's what we're going to do, and once again, NIL, it's an important piece of college athletics now. And so we need to make sure that we're staying abreast of it. We need to make sure that we're staying within the rules, and that's what we're going to do as we move forward.
Josh, you've mentioned the ups and the downs. That can you just put into words what, since you've been part of this back again, the ups and the downs and talking to recruits and having to explain it and talking to Kenny, and you know, Kenny talked about you telling him the good, the best case and the worst case, and the emotions that you've been through to try to stay positive through this whole thing.
Yeah, I think that's the job of a leader, right? To try to stay as positive as you possibly can, and that's what we've tried to do. I've tried to be positive but realistic. When Kenny and I had conversations as we were going through the process of hiring a head coach, it wasn't, it's no big deal, Kenny. It was realistic. Yes, there could be a postseason ban here. Worst case scenario, it could be more than 1 year. Best case scenario, I thought it was probably going to be the reduction in some scholarships and some things along those lines. And so I think you wake up every day and try to be as positive as you can possibly be. But like I said, make sure that you're prepared for everything else. And I think that's where we were with everything that transpired here. I think we stuck to the facts of the case. I think we presented them effectively. I think our outside counsel, our counsel that worked for the university, I think they did a terrific, terrific job. Like I said, we walked out of that room feeling optimistic. But once again, we needed to be prepared for everything in between. And that's where we're at right now.
Fred and Brett, we may have time for one more.
What would be the criteria to raise the banner again? And is the title not vacated? How does that work?
Those are conversations I need to have with the NCAA. Yeah, I this isn't just as simple as, you know, rolling down to the arena tonight. But look, in all seriousness, 2013 was an extremely, extremely important year to this program. And I think everybody knows what happened during March and the first week of April in 2013. And so while that's never going to be taken away from our fans, from our student athletes that played in that game, to recognize them is important to me. And if there's an avenue to get that done, then that's what we're going to try to do.
Just to that end, you know, that was a different NCAA case than one that was ruled on today. And I wonder if there are any new mechanisms in place or anything you can speak to since you become athletic director that make you confident that you guys are past this, that this won't be an issue going forward.
Yeah, in the NCAA or the IARP, they mentioned that in their brief. I don't know if 220 pages is called a brief. But they do mention all the mechanisms that were enacted, and you know, a majority of this was before I was in this seat. You know, we've got our compliance department that doesn't report to the athletic director. We've got regularly scheduled meetings with each of our various teams. Rules education, you just go right on down the list. And like I said, they literally outlined them in that brief there. And the other piece of it for me is just making sure that every day everybody's showing up to work and doing the right thing. And we have to stay on top of that. Once again, it goes back to, you know, you have X amount of employees, you're bound to have somebody who says, let's do it this way or that way, and we have to say that we're going to do it this way all the time.
Last call. Anyone else? Thank you so much. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
We know where it's at. Thanks, guys.